So I'm going to talk about the NextcloudPi project, which is a pretty young project, started on March, and I do on my free time. So first, a little bit about me. That's my real long name, but I go by nachoparker online, so you might have seen that blue lizard around lately. And I work as a telecommunications engineer, embedded Linux systems, and kernel hacking, and that kind of thing. But on my free time, I spend a lot of time trying to achieve a free and open source lifestyle, so running free and open source software on my phone, on my laptop, everywhere. So, and I try to self-host everything at home, so that's a lot of work. And so some friend of mine encouraged me to start a blog and talk about it just to share my interest, and so I did. It's called onyourbiz.com. So around March, I started sharing NextcloudPi, which is very simply Raspbian images with Nextcloud already running and installed and configured, and you can just, it's running out of the box. So I did it really for me because, in the beginning, because I have many things that I self-host, like I said, and it's fun when you do it, but then it gets really time-consuming, and it's a hassle to update them and keeping them secure and stuff. So I decided that it was a good time to automate the process, so I made an automated build system using QEMU. It also performed some tests, and the output of the process is an SD card that you can just use straight. So I shared it on my website, and I was impressed. People were very happy with it. So it featured in the cover of Raspberry Pi Geek, which is awesome, with the name Perfector Mini Server. So I took that picture because a happy user sent it to me, and it's cool because I had no idea that was on the magazine. And well, I'm going to thank him, but I don't understand anything because he's all in German. And around May, I was invited to join the Nextcloud organization. So what I saw and what I realized, and I mean, many people have already realized it, I guess, is that because Nextcloud is a web app, it needs to be run on a system. So that's what I identified as something that was preventing many people from using it, because it's already great, but you still need to install it, and it takes a lot of time. So most people were following tutorials. Many were updated using PHP 5 and stuff, and just copy and pasting things that they don't understand. So I realized that everyone was doing the same thing over and over again, and also some people were doing it to learn how to set up a web app or a LAMP stack, and I wouldn't recommend doing that if you're going to host your data. You might want to do it with some other thing because it has to be secure. Okay, so the goals of the project very naturally evolved into just making as easy as possible, because it initially had very good reception, but then there was an influx of new users that had more and more basic questions to the point that just basically Windows users that didn't know anything about the Linux, asking very, you know, I don't know how to mount a USB drive, something like that. So we already have very affordable hardware, which is great. We have many boards, not only the Raspberry Pi. And so the goal was to make it as easy as possible to have deployment, well, an image that everyone uses. And so if someone detects something to be fixed, everyone can benefit from it, instead of everyone doing their best to have a good implementation and, you know, some people get it right, some people get it wrong. And, well, in the very long term, as Nextcloud is getting better, make it easier for everyone to use it, so they can choose it to use it, not only because they care about privacy, but because it's better. So very quickly, this is to be expected. It's Raspbian with everything pre-installed. It had HTTP 2 and PHP 7 from the very first day. And it's already running for you once you turn on your Pi. But that's not enough, really. That's not all that's necessary to start using Nextcloud, unless you just want to use it at your house. So NextcloudPi is packed with extras. I don't have time to list all of them, but basically trying to make easy all the steps that you need to set, self-host your Nextcloud instance. So DDNS, Let's Encrypt, one click is working. You need to understand what you're doing. You just have all these things. There's some security hardening. It can open the ports for you. You have UPnP enable tell you to disable it afterwards. and so on. There's many things. So this is how it looks like. There's a web interface that is very new, and it just does the work at this moment. I came here. One of my goals was to get help on this, and it looks like I succeeded at that, so I'm very happy. So yeah, very, very simple. You just are able to configure your system with this. And there's also like a terminal interface, very similar to Raspi config for the same thing. This is how you configure Let's Encrypt. Very easy, just whatever domain you have registered, hit enter, and you have it running. It comes very ready to use an external USB drive to host your data, so you can move your data directory there very easily, and also other things, your database, your swap. And it's cool because you don't need to know what FS tab is because there's an auto-mount feature. So this kind of thing is what I was talking about. This helps lots of new users to be able to enjoy Nextcloud. You can backup and restore periodically or on demand. You can get updates from online, from internet, so you don't have to flash new images all the time, which was a must, obviously. And you can even have it be done automatically, so you just forget about it. You always have the latest thing. Same thing with the software packages. So this is on by default. The system will just use unattended upgrades to get the latest packages, so you're always safe and up to date. And there's some integration with Nextcloud, so it will tell you things that might demand your attention, or so if you have automatic updates, they will tell you, or otherwise they will notify you. And finally, so the build process also has a second output, which is a Docker ARM container. So I was very interested in your talk earlier, because I also like tiny images. I couldn't use Alpine. I had to use Raspbian because it shares the build process. So I wanted to have two outputs with the same code, so to be able to manage it. So it's cool because you're not really limited to using this on the Nextcloud. Sorry, on the Raspberry Pis, but you can run this on any board, that ARM board, that as long as it supports Docker, so as long as it has a not too old kernel, it will work. And also it's cool because it's easy to upgrade because of the layer system that Docker provides. So if you only touch the upper layer and you're smart about building your layers, you can have 10 megabyte updates, stuff like that. Looking into the future, so the next step, a logical step, is having a setup wizard, because we already have all these options to configure, but people still get confused. Do I need to click on all the options? In what order? So that would be nice. That would make it even easier. I don't think I have time for talking about Collabora, but many people are demanding it, and I was thinking I could maybe talk to someone here about cross-compiling it to ARM and putting it on a Docker container as well. I don't know how hard that would be. Finally, there's been some conversations in the forums to port it to other boards that are more powerful and have gigabit Ethernet, USB 3, SATA, and so on, and just work to make it better every day. All help is welcome. This is a lot of work. I do the documentation, the build process. I do basically almost everything. I'm getting more and more help with time. But it would be great if I could be more free to just make the thing advance faster. So another code maintainer would be great. So if tomorrow I fall off a cliff, the project doesn't die with me, that would be awesome. Web interface is very time consuming. Some people here already offer to help, so that's great. Porting it to other boards, helping new users, that comes with many questions, that takes a lot of time as well. And yeah, testing, just using it yourself and giving me feedback. Thank you.